O meu convidado é o Marco Pontecorvo, que é o diretor realizador do filme Fátima, de que nós temos estado a falar aqui no programa, e é um prazer enorme estar com ele, a conversar com ele diretamente, para conhecer este projeto. Thank you so much for the opportunity and congratulations on the project of Fátima, the movie.
Thank you.
You're welcome. How did this come about? Like, why do this movie now?
Actually, now is perfect, I believe, with all the elements that are happening and around the world, and it's even more interesting than when we talk about the movie. I mean, I think that there are elements inside of the story that are universal and always good to remind to us, to all of us. But in this case, I think it's even more important. So we arrived, I mean, they asked me to, they sent me a script, and it was not what I mean, I like something inside of the script, and I told to the producer, then I became also producer, what I like inside of the script, but how I want to change it. And they say that, okay, change it. And then how we start the process.
So how much did you know about the Fatima story of the pilgrims, the three shepherd children in 1917? How much did you know before you got the script?
No, not much, in the sense that I know the story because I live in Italy, a Catholic country, so it's sure that you know the story. But you know, as I believe 90% of the Italian knows, so there were three shepherds, they saw the Virgin Mary, but not much more than that. Then I start the research, because when you have to inside of the character of the story to understand the meaning of it and to choose your own point of view, you have to make some research. You cannot, I mean, just and that's I read all the books, Sister Lucia, then The Shrine, give me another book. I mean, I read a lot around, and this one permit me to rewrite through a precise point of view the story. Respect what is happening, for sure.
Well, Mark, how do you go about choosing the actors for this particular presentation of Fátima? You know, once you've decided, you know, you're going to be directing this movie, and then you also became a producer. I know that there's a casting people involved, but how do you go around picking the right characters for the movie?
I mean, first of all, you get in contact with the casting people that knows the places better than you, where you want to, because we wanted to have the of the actors coming from Portugal, that it was the right country. I mean, we had also coming from abroad, for sure, because Sonia Braga is coming from Brazil, Harvey Keitel, I think he's from New York. So it was Goran Visnjic also. I believe a perfect cast for this movie. All the elements, I think they were Marco de Almeida. I did Lucia Muniz, Joaquin de Almeida. I did all the meetings and we did session together before to understand if we wanted to make this part together, and if they were the right person. But I saw movies to understand who they, I mean, all of them, what they did, how they act, and was a very nice
past. Nice cast.
absolutely. And I think that the more difficult one were the children.
How did you find
the children? That was a very, also because in Portugal, I wanted from Portugal, but in Portugal, the law is not so easy, the kids. They can work very few hours. If there is school, they cannot work. So it was basically impossible to do the movie with them. So we went for Spain. And anyway, they have to talk in
English. You got lucky there.
we have been lucky. We did, but lucky, but we did a lot of work. We did a lot of audition, believe me, a lot.
How long did it take to do the movie from start to end? How long have you worked on this project?
Actually, it is a very strange process in the sense that we shot first with RVKTL and Sonia Braga. And was, I think, 2017, and the end of it, because they were available and we wanted to start anyway. Then there were a problem because I had already signed with another series, so I have to finish this series and I can continue. And that's basically what we did. We start at the end in September, I believe, of 2018. And we finish then with the editing and everything at during 2019, I think it was something like September. Mm-hmm. And now the movie will be released, finally.
It was
a long process, but very nice.
How do you feel about, you know, directing this movie and releasing it in under these circumstances where we're in a pandemic, where in some countries are still in a lockdown, you know, and in quarantine? How do you feel about that? How, you know, what's the experience like for you as a director compared to what you had before in other projects?
I mean, it's more a question mark for sure. We don't know what is going on the day after. And that's, but it's not only for the movie, it's for everything.
For life.
life. So it's, you have, in a way, to embrace the situation and take the best decision. And that's what we tried. And the other option was to postpone it another year. But we started, as we said, in 2017, then we showed it in 2018. We want to release it. We want to arrive to the public. We want to have the feedback from the audience. You do movies not for yourself, but for the others, okay?
Absolutely.
So you aim to arrive to the others. And I think this is a, in a way, is a good moment to release. That's why we choose to have not only a theatrical release, because we understand that the situation not in all the places,
right.
I mean, for sure in US it's not calm, actually it's the opposite. So we did also with the other premium VOD, so you have another possibility to arrive to the movie.
Right from your own home.
Yeah,
to exactly. Watch it from home, which is what everybody is doing, staying home.
Yeah, staying home, and if you have a night. I mean, for me, in a way, it's a pain because I believe that this movie, we really thought that was perfect also for the big screen.
Extremes, yes.
So, because Portugal is fantastic. Landscape and everything, costume. We did a lot of work, but nowadays everybody has a quite big TV.
So you can enjoy
that everywhere.
Well, in Toronto, it's being released with a special release at a drive-in theater, where everybody is in their cars, which is a unique way, and we will see it in a big screen.
Ah, that's fantastic.
In that way, we will see it in the big screen. Tell me a little bit about yourself, Marco. I apologize, Marco Portocorvo. Tell me about yourself. How long have you been directing, involved in the film industry?
Ah, involved in the film industry. I believe that I'm born in the film industry.
Okay.
Yeah, in the sense that my father was a director, very well known for Battle of Algiers, 1966. Mm-hmm. I mean, 5 nomination at the Academy, and is very well known director. So I grew up in the industry. I started when I was university and in the industry when I was 18. So long time ago, unluckily. I never finished. I was so involved in the business that I didn't manage to finish all the exams. I didn't took the degree because I was going at the beginning, studying, but then I was working more and more and more. At the end, I left the university, but luckily I studied enough to have a solid education. After that, I do all my career in the in cinematography department. So I was a DP, the director of photography. But I start from really, even if my father, but because he was very tough. So I start from cleaning the cases. Then I went loader, focus puller, first camera operator, and then director of photography.
Work your way up. And how many movies have you directed up to today?
Oh, I don't know. I direct, I think, 3 movies, but a lot of TV. Nowadays, there is a lot of series.
Absolutely.
But there are more series, actually, in our industry. Mm-hmm. And TV movies, a lot. Because it's I finish, basically, I did last 2 big projects that I did as DP was Game of Thrones.
Oh.
The first season.
Wow.
And a movie with John Turturro and Woody Allen called Fading Gigolo. A very nice movie. This was in New York, based in... It was my last project as director. As DP. After that, before I was going from one... I mean, I started directing... in 2007, 2008, but my last movie as DP was 2011. So there were an overlap of the 2 careers.
Mm-hmm.
Because if you love something, it's very difficult to leave it. But then in 2011, I said, okay, one of the 2. Otherwise, you cannot concentrate
on
2. They were a little bit too different, also in timing and all this stuff. And so after that, I direct a lot.
Mm-hmm. What's your highest expectations for this Fatima movie? What would you like to see? An Academy Award? What would you like?
First of all, no one would say no to your question. I mean, sure, if it comes, I will be very happy, super happy. No, I think apart from the awards, that I would like that this movie will really arrive with the message that it brings to the audience and that the audience can enjoy the movie and can think about the subject that the movie suggests. So I think this is the goal, our goal, including the fact that, I mean, this is also an industry, and this is quite an important movie. It's quite expensive, so hopefully there will be a lot of people that will appreciate and look to the movie. So also this one will be another success.
What was the budget for the movie, since you mentioned it?
The budget for the movie was I think the gross budget, because then there is the net, I think, is no, but the gross is 6, almost 17.
That's a pretty good size budget for a movie these days.
It's not a small one, but it was a very difficult movie also, with a lot of extras, visual effects, to really respect the story, and that's what we tried. You have to invest a lot in the movie, and I believe that you see every penny. The production value is all there.
It's all there. Great. Well, thank you so much. Thank you for the opportunity, and thank you for deciding to direct this Fatima movie so that the world can have an opportunity to know more about the story of the three children in Fatima.
It is a very important story, and I think it's even more important in this moment. I think that we managed to tell the story in a way that you can take it from different side, and you can enjoy, really enjoy it. So hopefully, finger crossed for all our future.
Absolutely. Well, thank you so much, and congratulations. And break a leg. Is that possible?
Absolutely.
not on vacation, okay?
Not in vacation. Thank you.
Thank you very much. It was a pleasure.
My pleasure.
Thank you.
I just started my training, and I am Liuna.
Para todos os seus serviços profissionais de contabilidade e bookkeeping, contacte a empresa Teixeira Accounting Firm. Para maximizar o valor do seu negócio, a firma Teixeira Accounting tem uma equipa experiente que pode oferecer serviços inovadores a preços acessíveis para cada cliente. Contacte Carlos Teixeira ou visite helpingbusinesses.com.